Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you, Dr. Adil. Dr. Adil is the ex-chairman of the Diabetes in Asia Study Group, and he was the one who introduced me to the group since about 5 years ago, and then the wheel going on, as you see. And so, on behalf of the Diabetes in Asia Study Group Board, I welcome you all here. And the Diabetes in Asia Study Group is an organization firstly established during a conference in Pakistan. Then the board have put in the constitution of the organization in Nepal, and you see Dr. Adil, Dr. Morsi Arab, I think he is coming in the road, and Professor Samad Shera, late Professor Samad Shera was the Secretary General of Pakistan and the Honorary President of IDF, and we missed him a lot, and Dr. Abdullah Hamak from Qatar, and the two from Nepal and Sri Lanka. And since then, Diabetes in Asia Study Group going on for the objectives of being a non-profit organization to create awareness, because we have a special culture and we have special circumstances in all our regions in Asia, and Egypt was the founder of the organization. So we have territory in Sharm el-Sheikh and Sina belonging to Asia, so we are there. And in the field of diabetes, anyone interested, any individual or any organization interested, can join this membership. The strategies to achieve the objectives is holding periodic meeting and conferences for promotion of the knowledge awareness in our societies, and conducting the studies characteristic for diabetes in our region. And let me admit that all those in South Asia are very active in this territory. We still going behind them, because since about 6 years in Bangladesh, I was me and Dr. Adil there. All the conference is papers, research, local research in the area, and this must be like this, not to follow the others in the Western or in other countries apart from our culture, but to create research that helping to answer the questions we are facing in our countries. And also for promotion of the activities of the organization, we have Journal of Diabetology, and Dr. Mohan, one of the famous diabetologists, as Dr. Adil said, go with the journal for New Horizons, and now the waiting list for the journal is a long one, and even the rejected articles now are enormous, and this gives the strength of the journal to go on. Also, we are in our organization seeking the collaboration with all the organizations in the field, either WHO or IDF or the local associations, and encouraging the development of human resources and the building capacity to fight diabetes. This is Dr. Mohan, and Dr. Mohan, and this is the website of the journal. I encourage you all to go there and see what you can benefit from publications in this journal. Also, we have a magnificent website recently innovated, and this is the address of the website, and you'll find it very attractive for you, because for the first time this year, we have this bilingual, Arabic and English, and this will create a resource for not only the physician, but also nurses and our patient, our people with diabetes. This is Dr. Mohan and this is Dr. Akhtar in the website. Membership is very easy. You can go to the site. You will have the icon of membership and you can click it, and then it will lead you to be a membership. And even you will have a vote and support for the life membership. It is about $100 for life and $15 per year if you want this annually. And this is the first DASG conference in Nepal. And this is the second conference in Qatar. You see the tallest one is Dr. Adil, and he's here. And this is Michael Harris, when he's IDF president. And this is the eighth conference in Cairo. We have it in collaboration with DASG. And again, Dr. Adil and all the famous UC, Akhtar and the man and from Saudi Arabia and from Pakistan, we have these people. This was remarkable, because in this conference in Egypt, we have also WHO collaboration, we have the NCDs, we have all these famous people to share with us. This is the last virtual conference in 2021. This is where I was elected as the president of the organization. And this is the members of the office. As you see, all the members of the office are distinguished people in their field. And now between them is Dr. Akhtar, who will be the president of IDF in the next trinium. He is now president-elect. Dr. Sandeed, who is president-elect for MENA region, and he will be president in the next trinium. And also all the distinguished figures you see. And so I call all of you, if you can, to join this organization for international collaboration as a window for us to go for some similarities in our cultures here and in Asia and everywhere. And thank you very much.